Thank you, Isabella, to be here and to have the opportunity to dispute with Gaspar Tamás and others. I would like to point that I share many opinions with Gaspar Tamás concerning the contemporary picture of our society, but I would like to concentrate on some point of this rule. First, we can get down the ladder into the theoretical basement of Gaspar Tamás' concept of post-fascism. What we can see there is the concept of Georges Bataille, which consists in to line the society as divided in two parts. The first part is called the homogeneous part, and the second one is the heterogeneous part. What we see in the homogeneous society is the order, the principle of exchange, the privileges, to living successful lives and so on. And on the side of heterogeneous society, we can meet the things like madness or unemployment and all things which cannot be included in the homogeneous society. And all the picture of post-fascism operating on this basement, on the Bataille concept of homogeneous and heterogeneous society. According to Gaspar Tamás, we live in a homogeneous society, which is diminished by the fact that people enjoy some civic rights and some privileges. Gaspar Tamás spoke about the prerogative state or prerogative society. And my first question is whether the members of so-called homogeneous or prerogative society enjoy this civic and social rights indeed. I mean that Gaspar Tamás doubt about it himself. We can observe the disconnection of civic rights and social rights, and in Hungary and maybe in Poland or the Czech Republic, even the civic rights have been curtailed, have been diminished. So I find disputable that we live in homogeneous society in the sense of Bataille. I would say that what happens around us is a paradoxic chemical interchange between homogeneous and heterogeneous society. We can observe the phenomena heterogeneism of homogeneous society. I mean by it that the core of so-called homogeneous society, we can find phenomena such as so-called white trash in the United States, or the chronic unemployment, and the classical example is given by the phenomenon of precariat. This phenomena can be considered to be heterogeneous. So the heterogeneous elements live in the core to the homogeneous society. So my second question is whether the concept of post-fascism needs concept of a homogeneous society. I mean that according to classical account of fascism, there must be a kind of homogeneous society here to fascism to work. But in the contemporary society, we can see another movement. It's the movement going towards the fragmentation of society and into the stratification of the society. I would say that the phenomenon of racism and xenophobia is out of dispute, but we should be very careful how to deal with the phenomenon. Well, there is something like a dark racist undertone in our society, as Gaspar Miklós, Gaspar Tamás, I'm sorry, put it. But on the other hand, we can find the fragmentarization and the never-ending process of splitting on the field of racism. Maybe many people share the racist prejudice, but on the other hand, they are cleft among many opinion groups. Some groups supports Putin, some groups is against Putin, some groups is for European Union, some group is against it, and so on. And it may be it can be compatible with some racist prejudice. My thesis is that it's practically improbable to create a fundamental homogeneous society, and that the fundament and or basis of post-fascism is lacking. Thank you for attention.
Now, Lukáš, you have the word.